We are now able to really precisely control light, to use it as a really, really fantastic tool.
It has coherence properties, temporal and spatial.
And the beauty of light is that we can very often look at molecules or a sample without touching it, without affecting it, without destroying it. It's a beautiful tool.
First, you need to understand how light behaves in different situations. It's like a toolbox, the magical toolbox.
Light kind of is not just light, but there are really different kinds of light. You can have not only different colors, you can also have coherent and incoherent light.
I like to see things which no one's seen before. And for seeing, we use light.
So there are many things you can learn from a spectrum that are otherwise very difficult to measure. And using that information, we can, at least in our fields, we can identify molecules, we can find and detect molecules.
We have a laser with very short pulses of 50 femtoseconds. We focus that on the tissue. We can visualize cells, cell nuclei, connective tissue in a few minutes. You can make the diagnosis faster and then save lives in that manner.
We take light, or we shine it into the eye, and when we look at the light that comes back out, send this light through some algorithms to find out whether there's a defect or whether we can find something that we can eventually do something about.
I work on new endoscopic techniques, making very small catheters that can enter the body. And so when you send light into the tissue, the light provides a higher resolution, and we can combine it with different aspects to get more information.
They are basically little photonic chips. You send the light from one side and you read it out on the other side. So in between, let's say a cancer biomarker goes and sits on top of your chip, and it changes the transmission properties of your light. And we can easily read it out.
We are developing new imaging techniques for many applications focusing on healthcare. It's a very thin, flexible probes. And this can be really inserted even into the brain without damaging it.
Well, one of the techniques that is really our specialty in our lab is the use of Raman spectroscopy. There are many examples of how this technique could be used in the future. I really hope we can try to understand better are the causes of Alzheimer's disease with the aging population. We looked at counting of microplastics. Maybe we can also find traces of life on Mars.
Big part of the things to come is using all of these tools to really build new platform. I like to know that the stuff I make is used or useful. If you have people that are excited because they can see things they weren't able to see previously, or detect things or characterize things, that's really exciting. You know, it's that.
I find it for myself, it's a great motivation. If you are able to improve something, you should do it to make lives better.
I want to do something that eventually has a form of impact on society, on medical techniques.
Testing cancer, right? It takes weeks. If you have these biosensors, they can easily test it within a couple of hours, then that will make a huge difference.
You can do so much stuff with light. It's such a nice tool which allows you to do imaging.
We can work on all of that together, and then it becomes more than the individual parts.